in the position where they can move into the top group, that is the top four, if they skate as well as they did in their short program. So it's terrific to have all three of our Canadian pairs in the top 10 here at the World Championships. Now watch this opening, split triple. Whoa, beautiful. Split first, that triple revolution, and he puts her down softly. And here's a throw, triple loop jump. Look at the height on that. That is incredible. They have another throw now. They're moving very fast, covering the ice very fast. This throw is double axel throw, 2.5 revolutions. He throws her in the air. She put both feet down, but that height and distance is just fantastic. That's the kind of skating that was exhibited in Regina when Matusik and Eisler came from behind to move ahead of Kuhl and Rausum. And they're exhibiting it again here tonight. Unquestionably, they are a pair to follow in the footsteps of Martini and Underhill, who, as we understand it, are skating the last performance tonight, but you never know. There's Carrie Leach again, has coached so many great pair skaters, puts them from one coast to the other, puts them together, and makes it work. Not only do they do these difficult throws, like this triple again, just unbelievable, and the lift, but they have style doing it. A 19-year-old Katarina Matusik from the North Shore Winter Club in Vancouver, and 20-year-old Lloyd Eisler from Seaforth, Ontario, both from the Preston Club. They're 3 minutes, 15 seconds into it, and they haven't had a flaw. Watch the one hand lift and puts her down with the one hand. Matusik and Eisler finished in eighth place in the Olympic Championships, just behind Underhill and Martini, but of course we all know what happened to Underhill and Martini in that one. And they hope to make amends for all of that tonight, and if by the short program yesterday, you can bet that it's going to be a grand finale. And that finale is the final move, forward inside that spiral. Beautifully done. Matusik and Eisler, standing ovation. Oh, they're so happy, and how can you blame them? They were gorgeous.
Well, that was a very technically difficult program. Katarina and Lloyd have the best throw elements in the entire competition. They're high, as you said, Otto. They travel the distance, and they're very solid. It was jam-packed with lifts and jumps. They did have a few problems in the side-by-side double axel, and I believe they had one other slip, but other than that, it was a very strong performance.
They had a couple of flaws. The audience certainly didn't think so. They appreciated it. Those throws that we talk about, look at this. Throw, triple loop jump. Solid landing, and you can see another throw now, that double axel throw. It's 2.5 revolution. Watch him throw her up in the air. Watch, she goes way over the boards. 2.5 revolutions. That was one of the minor flaws there. If you saw, she put her other foot down on the landing. I don't know if the judges saw it. Their lifts as well, Brian, were exceptionally well done.
Well, this is the star lift, and Katarina releases both hands, so she has no support. And the technical marks have just come up here.
All right, here we go for technical merit. 5-6, a string of 5-5s, a 5-6, a 5-3, and a 5-5.
Well, I think as far as technical merit goes, every one of those marks is deserved. And the artistic impression marks should come up, and I think that we'll have to watch those carefully, considering the choreography of their program and this and that. It could be up and down here.
Well, the technical side of it was well done and very difficult. And now for their artistic impression, we have a 5-5 and string of 5-4s, two 5-5s, a 5-3, a 5-5.